Genesis chapter 1, 1 through 8.
All right.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without and void, and the darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God saw the light that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. And God let there be a firmament, and the mist and of the waters, and let the waters and let it divide the waters and from the waters. And God made the firmament and divide the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day.
My Lord, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He made me lie down in the green pastures. He leads me beside the still water, and he restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He will walk through the valley in the shadow of death. I will fear no evil. You are with me, thy rod and thy staff that comfort me.
Amen.
Thank you. Heavenly Father, come out and be with us this Sunday morning, Heavenly Father, so we can continue to call upon your holy name, Heavenly Father, and tell everybody just how good you truly are to us, Heavenly Father, and true to everyone. This morning we pray for the sick, Heavenly Father. Pray for the ones in at home in bed of affliction. Pray for the ones in the hospital. Pray for the ones in the nursing home. And then have folks pray for one that old doctor that gave up on. But we know we got miracles every day from you, Jesus, Heavenly Father. We just want to say thank you, Lord. Just heal them where they're hurting at this morning, Lord. You know we all going through this morning, our aches and pains and the things of the world, Heavenly Father. We just want to say thank you for just being with us, Heavenly Father. And have folks pray for the bereaved family all over the land and country, Heavenly Father.
Thank you. Thank you.
realize what the little one was saying. All these blessings come from God.
Yes, sir.
Thank God, say that again. All these blessings.
All these blessings.
Come from God.
Amen.
Maybe you need to have a little talk with the Lord.
Yeah.
You live beyond our thoughts.
Yeah.
And so I live.
Yes, Father. Thank you, Father.
Yeah. Said the other day, my Father, that every knee shall bow.
Yes, Lord.
Every tongue shall confess. Father, we thank you. Can't thank you enough, my Father. Thank you for every second, every minute, every hour, every day.
Yes, yes.
Every week, every month, every year.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, my Father, for allowing us to be able to come out and worship your holy name. Let's all know, my Father, that that love will never belong to you.
Yes.
There's still land to rest on today.
Yes.
Bless them right now. Give them a hug.
said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, come let us go into the house of the Lord. I was glad.
Yes, Lord. but thou art rich. And I know the blaspheme yes. of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison,
yes, Lord.
That you may be tried.
Yes, Lord.
And ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful
yes, Lord.
Unto death.
Yes, Lord.
I will give thee a crown
that is
right. of life.
Yes, Lord.
He that have you,
yes.
let him hear what the Spirit has to say unto the churches.
Yes, Lord.
He that overcome shall not be hurt in the second death. Well, a few minutes, we're just going to talk about the church remaining faithful.
Amen.
Church remaining faithful. Grass, willow, flower, fading, waving, put by God's shell, and will stand forever. The church remaining faithful. Whatever trial we must face, we still must remain faithful. When the devil is throwing his darts at the church, like he did down in Southern Texas, we still must remain faithful. For every storm, for every mountain, for every troubling task, the church that Christ made the ultimate sacrifice of,
yes, Lord.
We must remain faithful.
Yes, Lord, amen.
Why is that? Because he always rewards those that remain faithful.
Yeah.
You got to look and ask for
now they are in the heavenly cheering section.
Cheering us on.
Cheering us on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they're cheering us on. When the devils, the devil, throw our way, we can make it.
Amen.
And the reason why we can make it is because we got the right God on our side.
Amen.
And
yes,
since we have the right God on our side, all we have to do is remain faithful.
Amen.
Because we know He will provide.
Yes.
Well, how do you know that He'll provide? I'm glad you asked. I talked to King David.
Yes, sir.
King David told me. As he looked all over his life, from the birth up until this part of his life, and he says to the church, I've never
seen.
See the righteous forsaken.
Say it, say it.
Nor his seed.
Yes, Lord.
Begging for bread. And since I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor have I seen his seed begging bread, I will take him and his word.
Yeah,
if I remain faithful.
Yes, Lord. I remain faithful.
I'm going to get a crown of righteousness.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Stand on the promise.
That's the best way to do.
Yes, sir.
Is to stand on the promises of God.
Yes,
sir.
Thank you.
And when you stand on the promises of God,
yes,
and you have in the back of your mind who you're working for, I'm working for Him who sent me.
Wow.
Over me.
Just remain faithful.
But you got but unto God.
Yeah, yeah.
Because see, we try to put our faithfulness on folk. But you ought to put your faith and be faithful to God.
Yes, sir.
And you got to say, whatever comes my way, whatever storm you send me to, I'm going to stay in your house.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to stay on bended knee. Yeah. I'm going to continue to give you the praise no matter what. As I looked at the text, kept looking, see John. Theologians call him old eagle eye John. He's been placed out on the Isle of Patmos. The crime that he committed was lifting up the name of Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Because he heard the master say, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me.
Thank you, Lord.
And since he can draw all men unto himself, he was just lifting him up. And while he was lifting up, man said, put him right there, old pal.
Yes, sir.
But he remained in his
faithful.
And whatever life puts you, you ought to remain
faithful
in the spirit.
All right.
You ought to remain in the word of God.
Amen.
You ought to remain standing on the promises of God.
Amen.
You ought to remain believing in the promises,
yes,
of God, that he won't put nothing more on you than you can bear.
Yes, sir.
All right.
You ought to remain faithful. So if he did for somebody yesterday, he will still do that same thing.
Go ahead.
Yes, Lord.
I hear you.
If he brought up in my situation on yesterday, I got to believe that he'll show up today. That's why I'm going to remain.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm going to remain in the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Not only on the Lord's day.
Yeah.
Right. But on Monday.
Yeah,
on Tuesday,
yes,
on Wednesday and Thursday,
yeah.
Friday and Saturday, and especially on Sunday, I'm going to remain in the way.
Yes, sir.
Wow.
That was Lord. Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
He was in the spirit.
What a word. What a word.
On the Lord's day.
Oh.
On the Isle of Patmos.
Yeah.
For some 2 years,
mm-hmm,
the Lord started speaking to him. And he said, I got a message for you to give to the church.
Yeah.
And I want the church to know to be faithful unto them. And I want Samaria to know I know your works. I know your works here. That was once alive, once was dead.
Yes.
But now alive forevermore.
Yes.
I know your works. Him who was crucified.
Yes.
And was buried. And rose on the third day. Knows your works.
Yeah.
Him who hung and laid his head in the locks of his shoulders.
Yes, Lord.
But was seen the other day in the marketplace.
Yes, Lord, yes.
Saying, go and tell my disciples to meet me in Galilee. He knows your works.
Yeah, yeah.
These past 8 years, Great Mount Pilgrim, he wants you to know he knows your works.
Yeah.
And he's telling you, just remain faithful.
Yeah.
Even in your organization, where you may just have 2 or 3 in your auxiliary, remain faithful with those 2 or 3.
Yeah.
Because God is trying to open the door for something that you're not ready for just yet.
Yes, sir.
But you got to remain faithful. Because Smyrna is going through something.
Mm-hmm.
And the church is under attack by the devil himself. But he who once was dead and is alive forevermore wants this church to know to remain faithful unto death. That's the promise that he'll give you something that the world didn't give. And the world
can't take it away.
But you got to remain faithful. A lot of us want the crown, but don't want to do no work. That's like you showing up at the pay window on payday.
Yeah.
And you hadn't been there 2 weeks. And all you get is a piece of paper. And you mad at the world with zero.
Yeah.
But when you get to heaven and you don't have any gifts, you can't say all the boy five little words under your breath. Bring three things in the text I want you to see.
Yes, sir.
I know your works. Verse 9. Christ lets the church know in some words, I know you suffering. I've been there.
Yeah.
And I can identify with your suffering. And nobody is exempted from trouble.
Amen.
If you are going to run this Christian race, you are not exempted from trouble.
Amen.
Everybody.
All right.
From Genesis to Revelation. Suffer some type of trouble. Everyone who lived for the Savior went through something. From Abraham to John the Baptist. And I stop by to tell you, it's some good news. Everybody that remained faithful to him got a welcome reward.
Yes,
they got an abundant reward. And you can have it too, and it may not come on this side. But when we get to the other side, you'll get a reward.
Yes, sir.
That you don't have to worry about moths eating it up.
Yes, sir.
You don't have to worry about somebody taking it from you.
Yes, sir.
You don't have to worry about locking it up, because what he gives you, no man can take away.
Yeah. Amen.
Because he knows your works. Job wants to come to the microphone all right. This morning.
All right.
Top,
all right.
Top.
Job said,
yeah.
I can tell you, you had exempted.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
No. But let me tell you something. When you know your God is real,
yes.
In the midst of your trouble.
Yeah.
You ought to be able to say some stuff like, I know
my Redeemer
believes.
Yes, sir.
And when you know for a fact that even in the midst of your trouble, John says, I start to stand stuff like this, even though the skin work may destroy my flesh.
Yeah.
Yet in my flesh I shall
see God.
Yeah. Job knew if I remain faithful and upright to him, you remain faithful and upright to me.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Not Ted Ginn. These past 88 years, somebody had a made up mind just like your people.
Yeah.
That I will remain faithful to the cause.
Yes.
Some deacon said I'm going to remain faithful to the cause.
Yeah.
Some preacher, some missionary, some choir member, some usher said, I'm going to remain faithful to the cause, even though I'm going through. Can we borrow a couple of words from the songwriter that will say, we are soldiers.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
In the army.
Yes,
we got to fight, even though we got to cry. We got to hold Why? Because we got a God.
Amen.
That know how to change situations.
Yes, sir.
Job said, I ain't do what you get. You know, God changed my situations twice.
Yeah.
I went from who's who to who that. And from who that back to the who's who. God knows how to change your situation. I went from who's who to who that. I went from rags to riches, but I went back from rags to riches. And God gave me double for my trouble.
Yeah.
Even though he made me slay me, yet when I trusted him.
Yes.
The reason I'm going to trust him is because he knows my works. Since he knows my works, and I know for a fact that he knows I'm doing it for him and nobody else, I'm just going to be just like Nehemiah. I'm going to stay on the wall.
Yes, Lord.
And I'm not coming down.
Yes, Lord.
And you ought to be able to tell your enemies, I'm on the wall.
Yeah.
I'm doing a good work.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. And I'm not coming down.
Yes, sir.
I don't have time for foolishness right now. Looked at verse 10 and I saw something. Fear nothing. Just go through. Fear nothing. Just go through. Jesus tells them, no. Just because I'm writing to you don't mean that trouble gonna stop. Some of y'all are going to be in trouble for 10 days because the enemy is going to come do some murder and wreak havoc. But you're just going through.
Uh-huh.
He says, while the devil is causing all out chaos, don't fear that. Just go through. Because every one of us are not exempted from a season of going through.
Mm-hmm.
Harvey came, but he didn't stay. He just came through. Can we go back? I came.
Oh, preacher.
But he didn't stay. We just went through.
Yeah.
Elisha came. All the storms came, but they did not stay. They just went through. Economically, it's the same way. The Great Depression came.
Yes, Lord.
But it just went through. Reaganomics came. But we just went. Bush came, but we just went through. Now we got trouble.
Yeah.
But we going through.
Yeah.
But even in the midst of that, we can look at the rainbow.
Yeah.
In the midst of the rain.
That's right.
And know we just going through. David talks about it better than me. And he wants to come to the microphone this morning and say, you know that scripture, that 23rd number of the song, I just didn't write that just to be right.
Yeah.
But I wrote it for you. And I had purpose in mind for writing it to you.
Yeah.
And it's to let you know that while you're going through, you're not by yourself. You got goodness and mercy following you as you go through. Why? Because it could have been a lot worse than whatever it is you're going through. But you got to look for the rainbow in the midst of your rain while you're going through. If he can get up out the bottom of the ship from being sick and say, peace, be still.
All right.
You got to look for the peace to be still. If he can heal blind bodies, he can help me go through.
Yeah.
If he can stop a funeral procession, tell the dead, get up!
Yes, sir.
Out of the grave!
Yes, sir.
You got to tell him, I'm just going through. Through.
Yes, sir.
Because whatever the situation you have, you got to believe Jesus can still fix it.
Yes.
I'm just going through.
Yeah.
Job situation, you just going through.
Mm. Yes, sir.
Home situation, you got to believe you're just going through. Car situation, house situation, children situation, you're just going through. Because when we go through, that's when we just break down and give God back the way it came from.
Yeah.
And you got to believe.
Yeah.
You're just going through. No sun lasts forever. I'll say it till the day I die. You got to look for the rainbow in the midst of your rain.
Yeah.
Through every mountain. You're going to make it through the valley. Through every situation that the devil may throw at you, you got to have in the back of your mind, I wonder how God going to deliver me out of this.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
No. I'm not going to look at the lightning. I'm not going to look at the darkness. I'm not going to look at the rain. I'm just going to wonder and be in amazement. How you gonna get me out of this? Whatever trial, whatever situation.
Yes, sir.
Well, Lord, I'm depending on you. How you gonna get me out of this? And in these 88 years, Greg and I, Pilgrim, can say it hadn't always been sunshine and blue sky.
That's right.
But God made a way.
Yeah.
I don't know where.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah.
Opened up a window.
Yeah.
And made a way.
Yeah.
I don't know where.
Thank you.
God.
Yeah.
And when you know the power of the God you serve, you can just say, I'm left going through.
Amen. Just going through.
When you get in your mind that you're just going through,
you have some peace.
Point three.
Yes, sir.
You know that after you looked at what you've been through, you result in the back of your mind, you're going to receive a great reward.
Yes, sir.
Right there again in verse 10.
Yes, sir.
Remain thankful to him who does all things well. Comes with a crown of life. I'm in that place. I'm going to call no more. No more suffering. No more disappointments. No more giving right for real, because I'm going to get my reward.
Yes.
And I just stopped by here to tell you, Great and Mighty Pilgrim, if you remain faithful to talking to him, one day you'll talk with him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If you remain faithful to living for him, one day you'll live with him.
Yes, sir.
If you the reason why Paul would pick up the pen and write to the Corinthian church and tell them to remain faithful.
Yes, sir.
For that same God that was taken from us, one day is coming back in life. Just as you are. The doors of the church is open.